In today's tutorial, I want to show you how to interpret Piper trilinear diagram. In our previous video, I've shown you how to plot your Piper trilinear diagram, and this was the result we got from the last video. After plotting your diagram, how do you interpret it? Now, the key is this. If you look at value here, you can see 0, 0, 0 at edges, and you can see 100, 100, 100 here. What does that mean? It means here is for magnesium. Magnesium is at 100 here. Y is at 0 here. Then here is for calcium. Calcium is at 100 here and is at 0 here. Likewise, the sodium potassium is at 0 here and is at 100 here. So which means as you are moving away from, for example, this is calcium. As you are moving to this end, calcium is increasing. As you are moving here, magnesium is increasing. And as you are moving in this direction, the sodium potassium is increasing toward this direction. So to interpret it, I have moved it to another sheet where I interpreted it. This is it. Now, I've demarcated it and I label it A, B, C, D, and so forth. This area for the cation, this area labeled A, it means calcium type, which means samples that falls here are very rich in calcium. This is calcium type. And B is no dominant type. You can see it falls within the middle. The middle, this is at 50, 50, 50. So samples that fall within this region, they have no dominant cation per se. Then the samples that fall here at C, C is magnesium rich. C here is magnesium rich. You can see that magnesium is at 100 here, 80, 60, as it decreasing. But samples that fall within this A region, label C, they are magnesium rich. Now coming to anions, you can see the anions here. The E is bicarbonate type. You can see E here. And here, for example, F is sulfate type. You can see F here. You can see that sulfate is at 100 here and is at 0 here. Likewise, chloride is at 100 at this point and 0 at this point. So, like this G, that you can see most of the samples here fall here at G, which means they are chloride rich. You can see many of the samples here are fall at G because chloride is at 100 here. So those samples here are rich in chloride. You can see G is chloride rich. Likewise, if you come to diamonds, you can see that most of the sample fall here at 3. So this is how to interpret the Piper trilinear diagram for your groundwater samples. So remember that, for example, magnesium is at 100 here and at 0 here. So as you are moving up, the magnesium value is increasing. So this is how to interpret your Piper trilinear diagram. Thank you for watching.